What's up, guys? It's Clownfight here. Guys, today we're just going to be reacting to some footage that's come out of Mr. Tyson Fury giving his thoughts on the Usyk fight. And guys, when you talk about delusional, when you talk about when punches hit your head and you get a bit of brain damage, or you're really struggling to take the loss, this is the best definition of it. Now, just notice how Tyson Fury acts like nothing's happened, but really deep down, he actually believes he won the fight. But I don't know. Let's just go through it and I'll give you my take, guys. So I'm just going to play the footage and then I'll give you my take as we go along. So let's go through it.
I'm chilling out, really. Probably been training 5 times a week. What else did I do? Went away in the caravanning with the kids for 3 days, one place, 3 days, another. That's about it, really. Just been taking life very simple. Got pissed up about 2 weeks ago, fell over on my face. Didn't do any damage though, still good looking. As you do, you know what I mean, when you're on a night out, son!
All right, guys, I'm just going to break what you just said there. So they're asking Tyson Fury what's going on, and he's addressing the fucking drunken fucking shit he did. He's addressing it. I can see a photo in the background of him putting Wilder on the floor. He must look at that every day, like it's an achievement. But fair play. I'm not gonna go into that anyways. But so he goes, basically, he's been just chilling out at home and he got drunk and pissed 2 weeks ago, as you do on a night out. He's trying to play it off, guys, that the him crawling on the floor, he goes, my face never got damaged. But he's playing it off. Obviously, guys, we already know, guys, Tyson Fury, It's not something new. He always likes going for a drink. But as I said, I've made a couple of videos on this before. I've never seen him in that state, guys, where he's crawling on his knees. But I'm guessing, guys, he's just trying to play it off here, guys. So I'm not really buying into it. I'm not saying it's not Fury being Fury, but I don't know, guys. I've never seen that. So he's just for me, the guy's just trying to play it off like nothing's happened. But the more you go into this interview, guys, you'll see how it is actually affecting the guy, in my opinion. Let's carry on.
But yeah, apart from that, I've not been doing much. I've had lots of messages and lots of people phoning me asking me, am I all right?
Look at that.
I'm drunk and I don't know.
Look at that, guys. People messaging him saying, yo, you okay? You okay? And let's see what he says.
Suddenly you're going to jump in front of a train. I'm not sure, but obviously from my past history, it's people are concerned. But yeah, apart from that, I've not been doing much, to be fair. Just been chilling out, spending time with my dad, my brothers, my wife, my kids. 3 training camps back to back. I had the Ngannou training camp last September. And then I trained after that. I had about 2 weeks off. I went straight back into camp for the Usyk fight that didn't happen with the court.
Go ahead.
Trained right through Christmas and New Year, all the way to early February.
All right, guys, he's talking about the training camps and stuff, and obviously he's saying he's getting messages from people saying, are you concerned about this? Like, we've seen you on the floor. Are you going to jump in front of the train? Blah, blah, blah. What's going on? And, guys, let's be honest, guys. That incident of him drinking himself to the point where he's crawling out, that's not usual, guys. That's not what Fury usually does. Fury does go and get hammered. He does drink. But, guys, he must have drunk so much that day, guys, that my man had to crawl out of the bloody pub like he was obviously Smeagol from Lord of the Rings, and I've already done a video on that. That doesn't come, guys, just by nothing happening. That's drinking away your sorrows, guys. You know, when you drink too much, why do you drink too much? Because you want to forget your troubles. So Tyson Fury has been affected psychologically. I've done a big breakdown of that on my channel. You can check it out, and you can see the effects here. And he's just saying, oh, I've had a three training camps for back to back. Guys, I'm not being funny here. Every single athlete has training camps back to back, most of them. So he's saying, I had Ngannou, I had this, I had that. Well, first of all, you didn't even turn up for Ngannou. You were eating Big Macs. And I don't know, guys, if that was the best Fury. Excuses were made. Now, your opponent, Mr. Alexander Usyk, he waited on you for after pullout, after pullout, after pullout, pullout. He went through training session after training session after training session. He didn't complain about it, guys. He didn't go to the pub and get pissed to the point where he's crawling on his knees. But for Fury, it seems like it's okay. But I'm going to give this guy a bit of a reality check. It's not okay, because if you want to beat this guy in a fight, in a rematch, I don't understand how doing that's going to help him win. If anything, it's going to make it worse. The beating in the rematch is going to be worse, unless Tyson Fury fixes up. But I don't know, guys. I know he's just saying he might want to let his hair down and do that, but guys, I don't know, man. That it's not what he done in the last fight wasn't enough. So he needs to do more. And getting pissed, guys, even though it was like 2 weeks ago, whatever, how he's saying, it's not good enough, guys. Fury should not be even like shouldn't have got to that stage, in my opinion. He had to drown his sorrows a little bit, guys, and I don't know. We'll see what happens, but for me, it's not good signs.
And then they had a couple of months off, and then a couple of weeks off, and then straight back.
You can't even remember how many weeks or months he's had off, guys, because he's like, I've had had training camp after training camp, had a couple of months off. The fight was like 2-3 weeks ago, guys, so he's getting a little bit lost here.
Back into the gym for the fight that just happened in May. So yeah, I've been training for quite a long time. It's good to have a bit of time off. But my time off is different to other people's time off because I'm still training 5 times a week. I watched the fight back.
So Fury goes, his time off is different to everyone else's time off because he's still training 5 times a week. Well, I'm going to give this guy a bit more of a reality check. AJ trains all year round, professional athlete. Usyk trains all year round, professional athlete. Now, don't get me wrong, they'll have time off, but they're always in shape. Whereas Fury, guys, we don't know. How do you balloon up in weight so much? Are you saying you're training every day? That's fine, because I know it helps his mental health. But I don't know if that's like benefiting the guy, if you know what I'm saying. Like, ballooning up in weight, or I don't know, guys. You should be training all year round because you're an athlete anyway. I'm not saying training camp, but you should be training. You shouldn't be ballooning up in weight. You shouldn't be getting pissed and crawling out of the pub, guys, in my opinion. I don't know. Maybe people are just going to say that's Fury, but that's drowning in your sorrows. You should be an athlete. So it's not really, there's no excuses here. If you want to have a chance at that rematch, guys, these are things they shouldn't even be questioned. You should be doing more, guys. You should be like, I'm training this now. I'm doing that. I'm locked in more. There's no more clubs, no more bouncers, no more fucking drinks, no more fucking Big Macs. There's no more chilling. I'm going to double down on my training. That's what I would like to hear from Fury. But we're not hearing that, guys. He's just still taking it like it's all good. Complacency, guys, is a killer. As I said, we made a video on this before, guys. This is the thing that's going to get Fury in trouble in the rematch.
Back lots of times. Still got the same answer. I thought I won the fight. Thought I did enough.
So, let's watch it again.
I've watched the fight back lots of times. Still got the same answer. I thought I won the fight. Thought I did enough. Usyk knows that he didn't beat me. People's opinions again, and this time the opinions affect big time. Close enough, you know. One of the judges had me winning by a round, one had him winning by a round, and that was the final decision. So it was what it was. I could sit here and say, oh, this, that, and the other, be upset about it and whatever, but I always believe there's no good in crying over spilled milk. It's done now, it's in the past.
Guys, all I'm gonna say is delusional is the best word for Tyson Fury right now. So he basically said he's watched the fight multiple times, and I've watched it multiple times as well, guys. Watched it multiple times myself, guys. I've studied it round by round. I've done a few breakdowns on my channel, so definitely check that out. And he's saying he watched it back and he still thinks he won the fight. I don't know, man. I'm very like, I went back, guys. I watched the fight without commentary, and guys, I couldn't give more than 4 rounds to Fury. Maybe 5 if you want, but that's stretching it to a high level. I couldn't give more than 4 rounds to Fury. Usyk nearly killed a guy in round 9, yeah? And he still thinks he won the fight. And the worst thing, he goes, guess what this guy just goes? Usyk knows he never won the fight. Guys, that's when you start becoming delusional. You remember that Wilder thing, guys, when Wilder kept saying, oh, he put something in his gloves, this, that, and he couldn't take it. Now, Tyson Fury is going for the same thing, guys. He's sitting on the sofa, guys. He's cracking open cans. I don't think that's beer. It's his energy drink, the Tyson Fury energy drink. But, guys, I don't like it. Like, he's just giving me the wrong signs, guys. It's just showing a lot of complacency. When you can't even accept you lost. Remember he made a video, guys, recently, and he goes, I accept the loss. I relish it.
Hey, guys, Tyson Fury here. Back in the gym, as you can see, counting down the days until I can get my redemption on Usyk. December the 21st, is going to be my time. I've done everything in boxing, but I ain't come back from a loss. And I relish it, the chance to come back and redeem myself. Get up, December the 21st is on me.
But really, guys, deep down, he doesn't even accept it. He thinks he won the fight. That's the biggest killer, guys. He thinks he still won the fight. And he goes, Usyk knows. Usyk knows he didn't win the fight. This guy's deluded, man. And then he's getting pissed and he's crawling out the pub. But guys, this is going to be the end of Tyson Fury. His face right now, cracking open that can right in front of you guys. It's not good. It is not good at all.
And I believe everything happens for a reason. And, you know, I thought it was my time. And obviously God didn't have his plan for me to win on the 18th, or else that I got the decision. But to be honest with you, it hasn't affected me anyway.
It hasn't affected me anyway. Just notice how he busts the can open. There's a video of him, guys, bloody crawling at the pub 2 weeks ago. And he goes, it hasn't affected him anyway. Guys, there's liars and then there's good liars. And then there's Mr. Tyson Fury that says one thing. But in reality, we know the case. It's obvious, guys, what's happening here. It's obvious, guys. I've done analysis on this guy multiple times. The more I watch this guy, guys, the more exposure he's doing on himself. I don't even need to do much these days. It's like this, guys. You make your bed, you lay in it. You know what I'm saying? Remember, this guy talked so much crap before the fight. Said this about Usyk, said that about Usyk. After my guy was coming up to him saying, very good fighter, this, that. Talked a lot of crap. Couldn't even look the guy in the face off. Was looking down. Knew his destiny was written. And now it's the psychological damage and the reality of the situation. Guys, I hope the guy can turn it around. But guys, for me, these signs are just showing me, I think he's going to get beaten worse in the rematch. Remember what happened to Wilder, guys, when he fought Fury the first time? It was a draw or whatnot. And then second fight, he got annihilated. And then he kept saying, I thought I won or he cheated. What happened in the third fight? It was a knockout. So I don't want to make no early predictions. Unless Tyson Fury doesn't change his mindset right now, this guy, it could end very badly for Tyson Fury. He could get knocked out by Usyk in the next fight. But guys, we'll see. I don't see any signs of what Tyson Fury is good thing that's good at the moment. He can't accept the loss. He's cracking open fucking energy drinks / beer cans. And he goes, I don't know what happened. He goes, Usyk. He goes, nothing's affected me anyway. And he's basically saying Usyk knows that he lost as well. Usyk knows he didn't win that fight. Delusional.
I didn't get a decision, lost a split decision, but could have went my way, could have not. I'd have been doing the same shit anyway. Undisputed champion or not, I'm going to still be doing the same stuff as I'm doing now. Dog shit, dropping the kids off, running, having an odd bee until I fall over. That's what I do. I don't really do much else.
So, he said that's what he would be doing whether he won or lost, which he might not be wrong with that. But guys, what I'm trying to say is when you come up against the best of the best of the best, the highest of the highest level, if you really want to win those belts, you have to give up some of these things, guys. Like him drinking a lot, whatever he's doing, it's up to him. I'm not saying it's up to whoever wants to drink, it's up to them. But you want to beat this guy in a rematch. How are you going to beat him if you're going to do the same thing that you did before? You have to sacrifice. He's not willing to do it, guys. If anything, he's actually chilling a little bit too much, in my opinion. But yeah, man.
I thought I boxed the head right off him for most of the rounds. Obviously, he had landed a good punch in round 8 and busted my nose.
Guys, the guy has lost his brain cells. He goes, he thought he was boxing the head off him for most rounds. He boxed the head off of Usyk for about 3 rounds. That was between round 4 to 6. And if I want to be generous, Jack, I would give Tyson Fury round 11 or 12 as well. One of them. That's it. He didn't do anything else. His engine started to deteriorate. He had 3 good rounds. But guys, after that, it was Usyk all over him.
Did a good punch in round 8 and busted my nose.
So round 8, he goes, he busted his nose. I don't think he's referring to the round 9. But I thought there he was referring to the round that he forgot, which he got annihilated in. But yes, he did say something about Usyk hit him and he goes, he busted his nose.
Round 9, he had a 10-8 round, so that's 2. And I give him round 10 of all, but other than that, I didn't give him any other rounds. I give him round 8, round 9, round 10. But round 9 classes as 2, so 2, 3, 4. I give him 4 rounds in the fight.
What a guy. this guy is delusional, guys. So basically, he gave Usyk the rounds where he got basically battered in completely. If you go back and watch the fight, you watch one round 1, 2, 3. Tyson Fury was on the back foot the whole fight. Usyk was pressuring him the whole fight. Tyson Fury had 3 good rounds between round 4 and 5 and 6. I'll give him that. After that, for me, Usyk's pressure was there the whole time. Usyk was dodging a lot of Tyson Fury's punches. Usyk was going to Tyson Fury's body. Usyk was constantly on him and landing shots. Not constantly, but he was getting more work on Tyson Fury. And you saw the results of that work by round 6, 7, 8, where Fury could not keep up with him anymore. So this is what you call delusion at the highest level. I don't know what to say.
I've got to get him out of there because... then I'm not going to get a decision, which is unfortunate because...
Yeah, now you realise you had to get him out of there. You had your shot. Now, try do that in the rematch and see what happens. But I don't know what to say, guys, sometimes. Sometimes I just don't know what to say.
Because it's hard enough to win a fight just by winning it. Never mind knowing you got to knock someone out. But I'm confident and, yeah, looking forward to the challenge. It was actually a lot easier than I thought it would be, the Usyk fight.
This guy goes, yeah, the Usyk fight was a lot easier than he thought it would be. You lost the fucking fight, mate. So, I don't know what to say to you. If that fight was easier, did you win the fight? You lost the fight. You nearly got killed yourself in round 9. And he's saying he thought the fight was a lot easier. Is this guy deluded? Or does this guy work backwards? Like, if you won the fight and you were saying this, fair play. But to say that you thought the fight was a lot easier than you thought, when really you got your ass handed to you, and you're only giving Usyk 4 rounds, what planet does this guy live on? I'll tell you what planet he lives on. He lives on the planet of cherry-picking his whole career and expecting to get the nod and expecting to Turkey to back his case and expecting to be the best heavyweight in the world. But when you get exposed, guys, it's hard to take. That's when you do turn to the alcohol, you do turn to the drugs, you do turn to the bad depression, or the dark dreary day, which Alexander Usyk's manager made a prediction on, and I've done a video on that, you can check it. This guy is delusional. He's actually turning into Deontay Wilder slowly. Tyson Fury is morphing into Deontay Wilder with these excuses.
A lot easier. People saying, oh, he's a hard man to hit. I was lighting him up 3 or 4 punch combinations.
Yeah, for 3 rounds you were, but what happened in after round 6, guys, what happened to your engine when he jumped on you and he hit you with that left and you started turning into a pinball machine? I think this guy lives for the moments he has, guys. He was lighting him up for 3 rounds, I'll give him it. He was looking good, but he couldn't sustain it. That's due to that can you got in your hand, mate. You're supposed to be an athlete, but you're living like a fucking moron. If you change your lifestyle up, you might have a shot, but it's not going to understand. Tyson Fury doesn't get it, guys. He doesn't get it. He's not doing enough. He needs to do more. Because in that rematch, guys, Usyk's going to make all these fixtures. He's going to make it better. He's going to be on his case again. And I don't know what to say to this guy. Complete delusion.
Laughing at him. My problem in that fight, I probably had too much fun. It was probably too easy. At times, it was too easy. It was like I was in there with a local amateur boxer. And I was just enjoying it too much and messing around. And he paid the ultimate price in round 9, where I got a 10-8 round. And got clipped, and that's what happens when you have too much fun.
This is what I meant, guys. This is the definition of complacency. A guy like this thinking that fight was too easy, making it out like it's a joke. All this showboating crap he was doing, acting like, oh, this is a joke. Guys, fighting Ngannou, having Big Macs before the fight, and then realizing, fuck, I never trained, and AJ kills him. This is the definition of Tyson Fury, and you think this guy can just wing being the undisputed, where you got a guy in Usyk who works hard, he doesn't pull out of fights, he takes set 30-70 splits, and he doesn't play into your games. This is where you get exposed for what the guy you really are. When you actually come against the highest of the highest level, for example, even AJ against Fury, I think it would end badly for Fury, and he's been avoiding it, but Mr. Turkey Alashik will make that happen, so... If this guy doesn't change and do a complete 360 in terms of what he's saying and mindset, and someone doesn't give him a slap in the fucking head, it's going to end worse in the rematch. That's what I'm going to predict.
And they always tell me, never mix your work with having fun. And I've always given them the middle finger and it's come back now, hasn't it, to me? But still.
I don't understand what's funny, guys. You giving him the middle finger, fair play, but mate, Watch what's going to happen to you in the rematch if you don't switch your mentality now.
It was good. I enjoyed it. It was all good.
It was
get,
all
get
good.
Get yourself well. I hear he's got a broken jaw and a broken eye socket. So get yourself well. I'll see you in December.
He's got a broken jaw and eye socket. He hasn't got a broken jaw. He had an injury with his toe or something. But it doesn't matter if he's got a broken jaw and a broken eye socket. You nearly got, you got TKO'd in round 9, mate. And you lost the fight. So at the end of the day, you put that can down. Get in the fucking gym. Stop crawling out on your knees. Stop putting videos out trying to convince everyone you're training. But guys, in 2 weeks later, the guy's going to be back on his fucking beers and shit. This is an energy drink, I'm pretty sure. But I don't know, guys. Tyson Fury, in my eyes, guys, he's playing it off like it was nothing. But we'll see, guys. We'll see in the rematch. Let's see in it. Because I don't know what he's going to bring that's different than the first fight. He even said in the press conference, guys, I did my best. There's not much more I could do. I was having fun in there. But that wasn't enough, guys. So you need to stop having your fun, mate. You need to start fucking getting serious. But we'll see what happens. But
for a Christmas extravaganza in Saudi Arabia, you don't.
Yeah, but that's just going to be my video, guys, on this Tyson Fury exposure, guys. Look at the guy smiling, but I don't know what you're smiling at. In my opinion, he's already accepting that he may lose. He knows he's going to get the money from Turkey. So fair play. He could probably take the loss, but I do think deep down it is affecting him because the way he's saying, oh, I didn't lose that fight. Pure delusion, guys. Pure delusion. But guys, that's just going to be my video on Mr. Tyson Fury, man. I've exposed this guy too many times and now he's doing his own exposures. I don't even need to do any breakdowns, guys. You could just watch the fight, watch what he says. At some point, guys, you don't need to expose anyone anymore. They'll just talk it out and then they'll be exposing themselves. In my opinion, Tyson Fury is now morphing into a Deontay Wilder. This may be the last of Tyson Fury. This might be the downward slope. He's coming towards the end of his career. Hopefully he can turn it around. I would like to see him turn it around, but it's looking very bad. But guys, that's going to be my video and I'll catch you in the next one.